Finally tonight, we add another book to our summer reading list. It's a modern take on what we can learn from tribal societies when it comes to loyalty, belonging, and the quest for meaning. At the recent Book Expo America in Chicago, Jeffrey Brown talked to journalist and author Sebastian Junger. His new book is Tribe, On Homecoming and Belonging.
Start with a definition. What do you mean by tribe?
The real and ancient meaning of tribe is the community that you live in, that you share resources with, that you would risk your life to defend. I mean, that's the real meaning of tribe. Of course, in modern society, that structure, that tribal structure, has been lost. That loss of tribe also costs people psychologically.
Did this grow specifically out of your work as a war reporter? Or?
Well, there was this puzzling thing that I noticed. A lot of the soldiers that I was with, I was at a remote outpost called Restrepo.
Yeah.
I was a 20-man position. Everyone's sleeping, you know, basically shoulder to shoulder in the dirt at first, and then in these little hooches. And it was very intimate, very close, very connected, emotionally connected experience. Mm-hmm. And after the deployment, that deployment was hellish. And after the deployment, a lot of those guys missed the combat, and they did not want to come home to America. What is it about modern society that's so repellent, even to people that are from there? And my book, Tribe, is an attempt to answer that question.
So tribe can be any kind of community? I mean, does it have to be a certain size? Does it have to be, how organized does it have to be?
Well, humans lose the ability to connect emotionally with people after a certain number, you know, around 150. So there's a limit to the number of people we can connect with and that we can feel capable of sacrificing ourselves for if need be.
What happens though when you're a member of a larger corporation, a larger town, a religious group?
I think the reason those things feel good is because they come close enough to replicating the connections of tribe that it's sort of familiar in human mm-hmm. terms. They're not tribes. I mean, the tribes, really, you have to live with the people mm-hmm. in your tribe for it to be a tribe in the sort of ancient sense. Now, what happens when society experiences a collapse, like the Blitz in London or an earthquake or something like that, is that people are forced into communal situations with each other in order to survive.
So you're looking at our society and seeing an affluence and seeing a kind of disconnection.
Well, the irony of modern society, for all of its very real benefits, mm-hmm. I mean, modern society is a miracle in a lot of ways, right? Mm-hmm. But as affluence goes up in a society, the suicide rate tends to go up, not down.
Mm-hmm.
As affluence goes up in a society, the depression rate goes up. When a crisis hits, then people's psychological health starts to improve. So after 9/11 in New York City, I live in New York, and after 9/11, the mm-hmm. suicide rate went down in New York. Not up, it went down, it mm-hmm. improved.
Mm-hmm.
Violent crime went down, murder went down. There was a sense of everyone needs each other, mm-hmm. and once you're called to serve your community, you, in some way, you sort of forget your own problems.
What's your sense of how technology has changed? Is the internet, you know, the much discussion about the communities that can form, small communities that can form on the internet. In some ways, we lose a sense of a larger community, but we have these niche communities.
You know, I don't talk about the internet in my book.
Yeah.
But they're communities only in the most abstract and unhuman sense.
So that's not enough.
Not enough. And actually, I would say the internet is doubly dangerous for all of its miraculous capacity.
Right. Right.
Not only does it not provide real community and real human connection, it gives you the illusion that it does, right? So, I've got lots of friends on Facebook, so I'm good. Mm-hmm. You're actually not good. And I, you know, I'm not an expert in this, but from what I studied from my book, Tribe, what you need is to feel people, smell them, hear them, mm-hmm. feel them around you. I mean, that's the human connection that we evolved for hundreds of thousands of years. The internet does not provide that.
We talk about things having broken down in Washington.
Right.
And then we're watching a political campaign, right?
Right.
Very much us against them.
Right.
Does the notion of tribes allow us to have a cohesion that we also think we need as a country?
Well, I mean, yeah, it's a great question. I mean, I think what you're seeing in this political season are political camps deciding that they're their own tribe,
mm-hmm.
and it's us against them. Mm-hmm. And I think the trick, and this country is in a very, very tricky place, socially, economically, politically, I think the trick, if you want to be a functioning country, a mm-hmm. nation, a viable nation, mm-hmm. you have to define tribe to include the entire country, even people you disagree with. Disagreement's great, debate is great, conflict is great, it's how we all get better.
Right.
What you can't do is have contempt for your fellow citizens. That is destructive. No soldier in a trench, in a platoon, in combat would have contempt for their trench mate. They might not like them, they might disagree with them, but you don't have contempt for someone that your life depends on. And that's what we're falling into in the political dialogue in this country. And in my opinion, that is more dangerous to this country than ISIS is. I mean, literally, like, more of a threat to our nation.
But as the tribe increases, the cohesion gets harder, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, one's saying this is going to be easy. But you do have to understand the task. You have to understand your origins. You have to understand why humans are the way we are mm-hmm. and what the cost of modern society has been. Once you understand, and that's what my book tries to explain, once you understand that, it's going to be much easier to devise, to jury-rig a new solution to a new problem.
So did all of this make you think about which tribes you belong to or your own tribe?
I mean, sadly, I grew up in the loneliest place in the world, in an American suburb. Like, I wish I had a tribe. No, we don't. We just don't. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the problem. I mean, that's why our suicide rate, our depression rate, all that stuff is through the roof. Like, I mean, that's the tragedy of modern society.
Short of a blitz or short of a 9/11.
Right, the apocalypse, right.
Yeah. What do people do in their daily life to find that?
I think if you imagine your life in terms of the community you live in, and you try to connect personally to the people in your community, even though you drive 40 miles away to go to work, mm-hmm. I think that's enormously beneficial and therapeutic.
All right, the book is Tribe on Homecoming and Belonging. Sebastian Junger, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And you can watch many more of Jeff's interviews from Book Expo America and other book festivals. You'll find all those at website pbs.org/bookviewnow.